Yes, good morning, YouTube. Common picture of a file server or NAS would be take an old tower PC, strip out all the unneeded boards, put a big power supply and a bunch of hard drives in it, load up something like free NAS or other operating system, and that's how you build a file server or network attached storage device. But I think the more correct picture, at least for these commercial NAS units, is imagine taking an old laptop, cutting the display off, and putting that in a chassis with a bunch of hard drives. So let me look at why I think that's more correct. So in the last video, we looked at this chart on Synology's page where they split up their NAS models into roughly three different groups here. The Group 2 models are models that can't handle any sort of video transcoding. And then you have this Group 1 Type 2, which is where my model sits. I have a 1513 plus, and the current model is a 1515. And then there's also a DS416. We'll take a look at some of these. And there's just a slightly different model up here. You have a DS1515 plus, and likewise there's a DS416 play that superseded this 415 play. So this is my model. It's a DS1513 plus, Intel Atom D2700 processor, 2.1 gigahertz, two cores, came with 2 gigs of RAM. I upgraded it to 4, which is the maximum memory you can put in there. And if we switch over here to the current Synology model, this is the DS1515. Pretty similar specs to what I have. I guess this one adds a hardware encryption engine. And if you go here to specifications, this is an ARM-based processor, quad-core at 1.4 gigahertz, limited to 2 gigs of RAM maximum. And if we pop down here on the bottom, they do give some transcoding performance data now. So it says 1 channel, 30 frames a second, 720p at H.264 encoding. So let's see what's different here with this 1515 plus model. So it looks the same, quad core hardware encryption, looks like up to 6 gigs of memory, pretty much the same I/O performance. But if we look down here at the specifications, you have an Intel Atom C2538 64-bit processor, quad-core 2.4 gigahertz. You've got 2 gigs of memory installed, and you can add up to 4 gigs of memory. And if we go down here to video transcoding, 1 channel, 30 frames at 1080p. So that one can do a little higher resolution video transcoding. And if we go over here, we can look at the 416. And if we look down here at the specs, you can see a little bit lower performance, only 200 megabytes a second instead of 400. It's again an ARM processor, dual core, only 1 gig of memory. In this particular unit, they don't give any transcoding figures for it. But let's look at the 416 play. So it looks just the same as the 416, but here, 4K video transcoding, and let's look at the specs. So this one uses an Intel Celeron processor, 64-bit dual core, 1.6 gigahertz, turbo boost up to 2.5, hardware transcoding engine, H.264, H.265. And if we look down here at the bottom, let's see here, we got 1 channel, 30 frames at 4K, or 3 channels, 30 frames at 1080p. So one thing I missed here was it only has 1 gig of system memory and it's not expandable. So this one is targeted just at home media serving. So let's take a look at what makes those systems different. So this is the CPUBenchmark.net page, and I've brought up a comparison. Here's what the processor I have, Atom D2700. This is similar to the processor in the 1515 Plus, and then this is the processor in the 416 Play. So if you look at clock speed, 2.1, 2.4, 1.6, doesn't really tell you much. And if you look at number of cores, 2 cores, 4 cores, 2 cores, again, doesn't really tell you much. One thing that's not on here is this processor is a single channel memory controller only, has a peak memory bandwidth of 6.4 gigabytes per second. This processor, if you add a second memory stick, can enable dual channel memory support, and you get 12.8 gigabytes per second memory bandwidth. Now this processor has an enhanced dual channel memory controller. It works with higher speed memory and can do 25.6 gigabytes per second memory bandwidth. So that doesn't show up here, but you can see the power is all pretty similar. So these NAS units are built to do low power. My unit is about 20 watts without any drives in it, 10 watts for the processor and about 10 watts for everything else. This one's a little bit more, this one's a little bit less. This processor, it says desktop, but it was really more of an entry-level laptop processor. And this processor here was actually more like a mid-range laptop processor. And then this processor is more like a low-end gaming laptop, as we'll see in a bit. And it's also used a lot in these fanless nano PCs that are targeted for home theater PC operation. And let's go down here. This is the passmark score for that CPU. So my model 844, the 1515 Plus, scores almost three times as high, 2329. And then this Intel Celeron in the 416 Play is only 1035. There's a bit of a performance increase on this from the 13 plus to the 15 plus, and not so apparent going to the 416 Play. Now, just as a comparison here, my desktop has a Core i7-3770 at 3.4 gigahertz, and it scores 9331 on the Passmark benchmark. And I've seen one page where they recommend 4,000 to 4,500 Passmark score to be decent at doing software transcoding. So let's look at this Intel Celeron. Why is this one so much better? So here's the Intel Celeron. It's a low-end dual-core notebook processor again, also used in a lot of these nano PCs. But if we go down here, graphics, it has a GPU built in, 12 execution units, 600 megahertz GPU. It says it's not powerful enough to handle modern 3D game, but the GPU supports 4K H.265 video acceleration right there. One other thing I mentioned in the last video, there's this FFmpeg is the library that's used for the transcoding on the Synology NAS. So if we go down here to their wiki, hardware acceleration. So this is all the platforms that support hardware acceleration, and there's a bunch of different options. The one that seems to be used is this QuickSync, at least on Synology. And then I think QNAS has just come out with a NAS model that allows you to plug in an NVIDIA card. And I'm thinking that one allows you to do this Linux NVIDIA option and you do CUDA hardware acceleration. But if we go down here to this Intel QuickSync video right here, technology allows decoding and coding with recent Intel CPU and integrated GPU. So this is probably what they're using. They talk about H.264 for 1080p and H.265 for the 4K video. But you can definitely look at this. This is your Intel-based Synology NAS models are going to be in this column. Probably the only similar thing, a Raspberry Pi, would be Linux running on an ARM processor. So this is what the like 1515 model is. So you have to be really careful if you're looking for a NAS to handle video transcoding or media serving. There's the 1515 Plus is totally different from the 1515, and the 415 or 416 Play is completely different from the 416. Now this Play model is really optimized at media serving, but it's quite limited in expansion. You can put four drives in it, and that's about it. You've got less connectivity, less expansion. You can't add memory to it, so it's quite a bit more limited. The big thing with this 1515 Plus is that you have more memory, and you can do things like add SSD cache. You can use some of the more modern file systems like the BTRFS. So anyway, I hope this video helps clear up some of the differences, at least under video transcoding, of these various Synology NAS models, and how you really have to look down in the specifications to find the one that's going to be able to do what you need. So if you have any questions about that, post up in the comment section below the video description here. And as always, thanks for watching.